हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल अनफॉग विद डॉक्टर अतहर परवीन। दिस क्लास इज बेस्ड ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन बेस्ड ऑन एचएसटीआर केमिस्ट्री सिलेबस। एक्चुअली दिस इज अ फ्री क्लास विच आई पिक्ड फ्रॉम पेड क्लास शेड्यूल। पार्ट वन क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस्ड एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल अबाउट द चैप्टर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन बेस्ड ऑन एचएसटीआर सिलेबस। नाउ हियर इन दिस पार्ट टू क्लास I'll be discussing very important trick to solve multiple choice questions based on bond length and bond order. Basically, this is a practice worksheet which I will be giving to paid class aspirants. Okay, I thought that let me make it as a free class to help other aspirants as well. So stay tuned till the end of this class, because if you are a HSTR, TET or GPSTR aspirant, then you must watch this class completely, because these concepts which are based on bond order and bond length, they are very much useful for any of your teacher recruitment examination. Okay, even if you are not a CB aspirant, then I would suggest you to watch it, because in GPSTR and TET this concept may be helpful for you. Okay, and most importantly, as I already told you, I am going to show you some very important, super and amazing tricks to answer the multiple choice questions based on bond length and bond order. Okay, now before starting the class, please pause the video class right now, take a book and a pen, and then come back and sit and watch the class. If you give few minutes to attend this class while practicing and solving the multiple choice questions which I will be discussing here, you will really have fun. Okay, so this class is going to be very interesting if and only if you take a book and a pen. And what I will be doing is, first I will give you introduction and I will show you the trick. Okay, after that I will solve more than 20 multiple choice questions. So what would be the good procedure is, you can pause the video when then and when I am giving the question. Pause the video, try to answer by yourself, then come back and play the video and match your answer with my answer. Okay, so first I will show you the trick, then you take it as a test along with me. Okay, so let us start the class. To start with, what is a bond length? Bond length is actually defined as average distance between the nuclei of two atoms. There will be bonding between two atoms. If there is bonding between two atoms, then the distance between the nuclei of two bonded atoms is nothing but the bond length, as I have shown in the figure here. So you can see that for atom A, the radius is RA, and for atom B, the radius is RB. Now the distance between the center of atom A and the center of atom B will give you the bond length. Okay, the bond length for this system. Now the unit for bond length is picometers. Picometers. Okay. Now coming to bond order, this is nothing but the number of chemical bonds between a pair of atoms. In a molecule, if there are multiple bonds, then bond order will be the sum of the number of bonds between those two atoms. Okay, for example, if there is a double bond, the bond order will be 2. If there is a triple bond, bond order will be 3. Okay, so here I have given you the example of carbon monoxide. There are 3 bonds between carbon and oxygen, so the bond order will be 3. Now how are bond length and bond order related? Actually, bond length and bond order are inversely proportional to each other. That means, if the bond order increases, bond length will decrease. Why is it so? Because electrons involved in bonding, they are held more tightly. When the bond order will increase, the bonding will be very strong, and this will pull the nuclei closer together. Okay? So bond length is inversely proportional to bond order. Apart from this, bond length is also affected by size of atoms which are involved in bonding. If the atoms are larger, then they have longer bond lengths, because distance between their nuclei will be greater, right? You can see here in this picture which I have shown you. See, if the atom A is small, so the radius is small. atom B is big, so the radius will be big. So if the radius is big, means bond length will increase, right? So that is how I am telling that the bond length will be affected by size of the atoms. Larger the atoms, longer will be the bond lengths. Okay. Bond length and bond order, they are also important factors in determining properties of a molecule. How short bond lengths will typically correspond to stronger bonds, and the molecules which are having stronger bonds will tend to be more stable. So you can judge whether the given molecule is stable or not by understanding or finding out the bond length and bond order of the molecule. Also, this bond length and bond order can be calculated using some techniques like spectroscopic techniques or computational methods. Also, maybe you can use X-ray crystallography, infrared spectroscopy, and quantum mechanical calculations. With all these calculations, we can find the bond length and bond order. In fact, my research area was also related to this quantum mechanical calculations. I could run some computational programs, and I could find the bond length, bond order, and many other details about the atom and molecule. Not only this, we can use bond length and bond order to find the electronic structure of a molecule. So this is a very detailed analysis. Electronic structure is a detailed analysis of a molecule. So you can understand with this only that how important is calculation of bond length and bond order. It will allow you to find the electronic structure of a molecule. Okay. See, for example, you have a molecule which is having short bond length, and obviously if bond length is short, bond order will be high. Okay. It means that the molecule is more rigid. Okay. It is very like tightly bound. Okay. And you can find the linear geometry, while molecule with longer bond length, and obviously it will have lower bond order, this will have more flexibility. For example, a molecule which is having a shorter bond length, obviously it will have higher bond order. So this type of a molecule with shorter bond length and higher bond order will have more rigidity. That means it will be having linear geometry. In the opposite case, that is when a molecule is having longer bond length and lower bond order, that type of a molecule will have a bent geometry. That means it will be flexible. Okay, even these things you can know from bond length and bond order. Now coming to the trick to calculate bond order. See, now your book work starts. You need to write down from now. Okay. Now, what is the trick to calculate bond order means? If you want to follow this trick, you should know number of electrons in that particular atom or in the molecules or in the given ion. Okay. Either it is an atom or it is a molecule or it is an ion, you should be able to find number of electrons. If you know number of electrons, then bond order is given here. That means if number of electrons for that system, either atom, ion or molecule, is 14, then the bond order will be 3. If number of electrons will be 13, bond order will be 2.5. Okay, that means 14 is in the middle. If you go in the decreasing manner, in the upward direction, that is 13, 12, 11, 10, bond order will go on decreasing. Okay, it will be 2.5, 2, 1.5, 1 and so on. Now, if you come below this 14 number, here also bond order will be decreasing, 2.5, 2, 1.5, 1. Okay, so bond order will decrease above 14 also, it will decrease below 14 also. Okay, so this is clear, right? So this is the trick to calculate bond order. But I will say that this is a trick to calculate bond length also, because we know that bond order is inversely proportional to bond length. So I can find bond order and I can also guess what will be the bond length, because it is inversely proportional, right? For example, if the bond order is increasing, then bond length will decrease. If bond order is decreasing, bond length will increase. Correct? Okay. Now, to find the number of electrons, what you do, I have a trick for that also. See, Simple thing is, if you are given one atom or element, you will be knowing number of electrons by knowing the atomic number from the periodic table. Okay, directly, right? Hydrogen is 1, helium is 2, lithium is 3, beryllium is 4, and so on. So I am giving you few important elements list here. So these are the number of electrons in these elements. Okay, till bromine I have. Now this directly, if you are having an element, then you will be knowing number of electrons. But if you will be having some ion, say for example, if the ion is having plus sign, it means that the number of electrons is less. Okay, so actual element, see for example, if you have chlorine, number of electrons are 17. If you have plus on chlorine, I'm just giving you example, if you have plus on chlorine, it means that there is only plus 1. Okay, it means that the number of electrons are 16. Okay, if you have minus on chlorine, Cl minus 1, it means that the number of electrons are 18. Okay, so this is a simple funda that a chemistry student should know, right? So plus sign means number of electrons will be less, and minus signs means number of electrons will be more. Okay, plus 1 means 1 electron will be less, plus 2 means 2 electrons will be less, minus 1 means 1 electron will be more, minus 2 means 2 electrons will be more. Okay, this I assume that you already know. For example, I have this hydrogen molecule. Number of electrons in a hydrogen atom, one single element, is only 1 electron, right? We have a hydrogen molecule with 2 hydrogen atoms. So number of electrons will be 2 in this molecule. Okay, for helium, number of electrons in one single helium atom is 2, right? But in this molecule, there are 2 helium atoms. So number of electrons will be 4. And for lithium, number of electrons in a single element or atom of a lithium is 3 electrons, right? So if I have a molecule containing 2 lithium atoms, that means number of electrons will be 2, 3 is 6. Like that only for beryllium, it is 2, 4 is 8. For oxygen, it is 2, 8 is 16. But when we come to this molecule containing 2 different type of atoms or more than that, what you will do, you will add up. You will add up the number of electrons. Like for example, if I have carbon dioxide, it is consisting of 1 carbon atom and 2 oxygen atoms. So each oxygen atom is having 8 electrons and each carbon atom is having 6 electrons. But I have a molecule of oxygen with 2 oxygen atoms. So 8 2s are 16. Plus carbon is 6, right? 8 2s are 16. 16 plus 6 will give 22 electrons. So carbon dioxide is having 22 electrons. Okay. So in that trick table, you will use the number of electrons as 22. Okay. Next, for nitrogen. Nitrogen is having 7 electrons, right? But here we are talking about a nitrogen molecule with 2 nitrogen atoms. So number of electrons will be 7 2s are 14. Okay. Now speciality of this nitrogen is that it is a non-polar molecule. So it will not have a charge and it will not gain or lose any electrons or protons. Okay, basically it will not lose or gain electrons. Okay. Now let's first discuss 2 or 3 important multiple choice questions. Then directly we will go to the practice worksheet. Okay. And this practice worksheet will be given to the paid aspirants. Okay, I will give you the PDF as usual. I will be giving for every chapter now. Like that, I will give this also along with the class. Okay. So the first example is, which of the following bonds would have the shortest bond length? See, very interesting. Here you can easily find the bond order. Correct. See, the bond order, more the bond order, less the bond length. They are telling shortest bond length. So you find the largest bond order, highest bond order you find. Which is the highest bond order? Option C, right? Because the carbon atoms are having 3 bonds. So bond order will be 3. So bond length will be the minimum for this. So option C will be the correct answer. Okay. Next question. The bond order in a diatomic molecule is related to, so the bond order, the electronegativity of the atoms, the number of valence electrons, the ionization energy of the atoms. So directly, bond length in a diatomic molecule, it will be related to a bond order only. Okay, so option A will be the
करेक्ट आंसर।
The bond length in a covalent bond is, obviously it is the distance between the two atomic nuclei, right? So option A will be the correct answer. Now it has become very easy for us, right? We have discussed all these things, so it has become very easy. Next question. Which of the following factors affect the bond length? Bond order, atomic radius of the bonded atoms, electronegativity of the bonded atoms, all of the above. Actually, all these three options are the factors which are affecting the bond length. So all of the above will be the correct answer for this question. Okay. Now we start the practice worksheet. So get ready, friends. You have to solve the MCQs along with me using the trick. Okay. First question. Which of the following molecules has the highest bond order? For this, I will give you a clue. O2 will have 16 electrons, right? So here there is a plus one. That means one electron is less. So it will have 15 electrons. O2 minus 1. That means one electron is more. So this 16 plus 1. It will become 17. And O2 2 minus means 16 electrons are originally there. And 2 electrons are increased. 2 minus, right? So it will have 18 electrons. Now you have to see the bond order of each thing. See our trick. What is the question? Which of the following molecules has the highest bond order? So highest bond order is 3, right? 14. So 14 is there? No. Next highest is 2.5. That means it should be 13 or 15. So this one will be the correct answer. 15. Correct? See. This is for 14. This is for 13. This is for 15. We don't have 15. Next highest after 3 will be 2.5 only, right? So O2 plus will be the correct answer. Okay. Next question. Now pause the video and try to answer this question by yourself. Okay. I have given you another option also. O2 and O2 minus. Now pause the video and try to solve it by yourself. Okay. I hope that you have solved it. See what we have to do. For carbon monoxide, number of electrons will be 14. For carbon dioxide, number of electrons will be 22. Now you know the procedure how to find the number of electrons, right? Just add up. For oxygen you have 8 and carbon you have 6. So carbon monoxide will be 6 plus 8 will give you 14. And so on. You do it for carbon dioxide, N2, N2 plus. For all those you have to do. Okay. So I'll give you directly number of electrons. Okay. Here it is 14 and here it will be 13. And hydrogen it will be 2. And H2 plus will be 1. Oxygen will be 16 and O2 minus will be 17. Okay. So you have to find the shorter bond length. Shorter bond length means highest bond order. This you should know. Okay. Highest bond order. Obviously, it will be N2 and N2 plus. Because N2 and N2 plus are 14 and 13, right? See, 14 and 13. 2.5 and 3. Okay, 2.5 and 3 is the highest one. 14 and 13. Okay. Next question. Which of the following molecules has the longest bond length? That means lowest bond order. What you do here? Find the number of electrons. HCl you have hydrogen will be 1 and fluorine will be 17. So you will have number of electrons will be 18. And for hydrogen bromide you will have number of electrons will be 36, I think. 35 and 1. It will be 36. For hydrogen and iodine you will have 54. 1 plus 53, right? Hydrogen and fluorine, you will have 1 plus 10. It will be 11, I think. No, fluorine is 9, right? It will be 1 plus 9. 1 plus 9. So, it will be 10. Okay. I am giving you number of electrons. Now, you have to find which one is the correct answer. Remember that bond length is inversely proportional to bond order. Okay. Similarly, I have list of questions. I will scroll down slowly. You can pause the video each and every time and try to solve the answers by yourself. Okay, so this is the fourth question. This one is the fifth question. Here I will give you the option. It is not visible, right? It will be n 2 minus 2 is there here. Okay, n 2 2 minus is there. Next question, which of the following molecules has the shortest bond length? So you have to write the number of electrons first. Okay, you write down the number of electrons. This will be 2, this will be 14, this will be 16, this will be 18, correct? Then you use the trick of the table. Okay, then find the shortest bond length. What is shortest bond length? Shortest bond length means highest bond order. Okay, next question. Which of the following is true about bond order? Obviously, we already know that bond order is inversely proportional to bond length. Okay, actually there is something else also. Number of bonding atoms minus number of antibonding atoms upon 2. But I am not getting into that situation because some aspirants may find it difficult. Okay, I am giving you simple trick to find the tough questions also. You can find the answers to the tough questions using this simple trick. Okay. Next, which of the following pairs of molecules has the highest bond order? Now, highest bond order directly you can find from the table. Only thing is you have to find the number of electrons. So, what is carbon monoxide is 14. Carbon dioxide will become 22. And nitrogen oxide will be 15. This one will be 14. Correct? This one will be 16 and this one will be 15. This one will be 14 and this one will be 13. Okay. You have to see which one is having the highest bond order. Obviously 14 and the 13 only, right? So that will be the correct answer. N2 and N2 plus. Similarly, you have ninth question. You can pause and you can note down the options. Again, I'm giving you a table so that you will not find it difficult to learn this table. Okay. Next, which of the following molecules has the longest bond length? Okay, I'm giving you answer also, but then your answer should match with mine. You should have justification for that answer. Okay. Next, this is question number 11. Okay. Then 12. This is interesting, right? Which of the following molecules has a bond order of 2? Proper 2. Which is the bond order 2, they are telling. So this one will be number of electrons will be 14, this one will be 22, this one will be 16 and this one will be 15. Okay, so bond order 2 means it should be either 12 or 16, right? So 12 or 16, so this will have bond order 2. Okay, next question. Which of the following pairs of molecules has the same bond order? This is an important question, I feel. Okay, so if you find the number of electrons, no, here you will find that fluorine will have 9 2s are 18, right? F2 is there. Here oxygen 6 2s are 8 2s are 16 plus 2 electrons because minus 2 is there, right? So this will imply that both are having same number of electrons, 18. So same number of electrons means same bond order. So option D will be the correct answer. Okay. Next question. Which of the following molecules has the highest bond order? So if you see the options carefully, I think here you will have maximum, I think 14 electrons will be there. So bond order will be 3, right? So that is the maximum thing. So option D will be the correct answer. Okay. Similar question. You have to try this. Okay. Question number 16. And question number 17 also you have to try by yourself, or I will solve it for you. Which of the following molecules has the bond order of 1.5? We need 1.5. okay, we can go for the table. 1.5 means it should be either 11 or 17. Okay, let us see number of electrons. NO plus will be 14, this will be 16, this will be 15 and this will be 17. Okay, so 1.5 means it should be option D. Okay, Which of the following molecules has the longest bond length? So longest bond length means shortest bond order, right? So this will be 14, this will be 22, this will be 32, and this will be 40. So this will be the smallest bond order. Okay. It will be less than 0 or something like that. Okay. So it means that it is having the longest bond length. So option D will be the correct answer. Okay. So without going into much details about bonding and antibonding, we were able to solve the problems based on bond length and bond order. Okay. And please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You can also join my Telegram channel. Okay. The link of the Telegram channel will be given in the description. And also if anyone is interested to join the CB course, HSTR CB course, the details will be given in the below description. Okay. Below this video, you can join the course also. Okay. Thank you. All the best. Bye.